Hi friends, I have a very special topic for you today, and it is the most chronic disease called anxiety. Any disease, if not attended well in time, but kept prolonged due to sheer neglect, turns out to be chronic. It becomes chronic, it takes long duration for healing, and sometimes it can become so worse that it could be the fatal end of the person. We therefore need to be extremely sensitive towards the welfare of our body. If it is so regarding our physical body, what will be the case regarding our mind? The mind too demands our attention, care and sensitivity so that it can function well. We have already produced a video on mental well-being and explained to you how we need to take care of our mind and be concerned about its well-being. Even if you schedule your program with sufficient care and attention to mental health, sometime or other, all human persons, whether young or adults or seniors, invariably become victims to a mental illness called anxiety. Of course, there will be difference in intensity in its manifestations from one person to the other. It means some are more anxious and some others are less prone to anxiety. In this video, I would like to explicate the common causes of anxiety, and maybe we need another video to deal with it more elaborately. But all of us must have some knowledge of this mental sickness so that we can be on our guard. When we know the causes or reasons why we get into anxiety, we can be careful and on the watch to minimize its efficacy. The problem regarding anxiety is that we considered it as a normal experience of life and neglect it. I have appeared for exam and it is normal to be anxious about the results. I was irregular for classes, so it is normal to be anxious when exam come near. I have never went for practice, now anxious regarding my performance in the competition, so on and so forth. If these are just passing experience, well and good, you can return to the normal state of mind and resume again your daily life once the event is over. But sometimes what seems to be normal can give rise to abnormality very easily. I am anxious, so I cannot sleep at all. I am anxious, so I do not experience taste at all. I am anxious, so I cannot participate in any common activity. I feel lifeless. All these symptoms are not ordinary and demand further attention. Positive aspect of anxiety. But there is a positive type of anxiety which accompanies any intense creative activity. The ISRO staff is ready with the satellite to land on the planet Mars, and the time is approaching to shoot off the rocket, and millions of people are watching. So the ISRO staff is terribly anxious whether it will smoothly land on the planet Mars. This is something positive. Another example, you have practiced well for months together for the school day program, and when the day comes to perform, you become anxious. This is also a positive type of anxiety. Once the event is over, and if you are mature enough to accept the result, whether positive or negative, you can return to your normal self and resume your life without much anxiety. This type of anxiety is a part of personality development. You come out fulfilled and mature after the experience. Though anxiety in itself is never a comfortable feeling, but sometimes a small dose of anxiety brings out best in us. It makes us creative, impels us to work hard, and brings the best out of us. The negative aspects of anxiety. But anxiety has innumerable characteristics which are totally negative. It is considered as a psychological illness, and countless people suffer from its effects. So we need to delve deeper into the reasons or the causes of anxiety so that we are aware why it is troubling us when we ourselves become victims of it. Any neglect can lead to a chronic condition, giving rise to anxiety disorders which are bound to make our life miserable. Here are the common causes of anxiety. Overthinking. Overthinking or rumination can easily give rise to anxiety. This is a habit of thinking too much on anything that happens around you. If someone smiles at you, you start thinking, why he smiled at me? What may be the reason for it? What may be the implications of it? What may be the purpose of it? So on and so forth. You received a missed call. At once you become restless, distracted, dissipated, and your mind gets into wild imaginations. One day there was a long procession on the road, and you were held up and delayed reaching home. That makes your mummy restless, and her mind gets into the journey of wild speculations. What happened to my child? Why he is so late? Whether the bus met with an accident? Whether anyone was there to help my child? Whether he got wounded, fractured? Whether taken to the hospital, which hospital, so on and so forth. This is excessive thinking, and if it is a regular affair, you become a person ridden with anxiety disorder. Holding on to unrealistic goals can also produce anxiety. Regular work followed by regular rest and relaxation keeps your mind and body healthy. But sometimes some people want to achieve too much too soon. As a result, they become impatient. Sometimes you set goals for yourself which you cannot achieve, but you struggle, work hard, get disappointed unnecessarily, become jealous of others who are able to achieve more than you. Then you become workaholic, forget to relax, work over time but never satisfied with what you achieve and what you earn. Finally, land into anxiety disorder. So, be careful with your goals and objectives. Both mind and body are limited in their capacities. Be aware of your limitations and have enough self-knowledge to order your daily schedule of work. It is normal to aim at 70% in the next exam. If you have 60% in the last exam, but it is imprudent to set the goal of 90%, know that such a big jump is humanly impossible and you may land into anxiety disorder. Low self-esteem. A negative self-image is due to low self-esteem. You yearn to impress everybody, but within you experience some sort of insecurity. You become overcautious, easily yield to fear and avoid taking up any challenges and risk in life. You never learn driving because you think anytime you can have an accident. Never speak in public because you think others may criticize you and put you down. You get too much preoccupied with what others think of you. All this can easily lead to anxiety. Pessimistic attitude. An overdose of pessimistic attitude can also lead you to anxiety. This is actually another kind of a mind trap. You are often preoccupied and worried regarding worse things that can happen to you. You can never see a positive aspect of any event or any person. You become too much worried about evil and sufferings that may come to you. There are some students who repeat, "I can never get more than 50%. I can never go on the stage and appear before the public." If you go on thinking like that, you will get into anxiety as the exam date approaches. And whenever you have to stand on the stage, which obstructs your performance. Positive affirmations can certainly help you to overcome your pessimistic attitude. Traumatic events of the past. Anxiety might be caused by some shocking and traumatic event that occurred in your life in the past. You may not even be aware of the incident happened in your life, but it can influence your present behavior. Sometimes we think, why I feel this way, why I act this way, why this phobia, why do I hate reptiles or particular colors, and why do I become unconscious as soon as I see blood and the like. All these behaviors are due to traumatic experience of the past. We become anxious for no reason. We become fearful and develop phobias for no known reasons. But your unconscious has stored, like a hard disk of the computer, all your past experience and they influence your present behavior. Conclusion. In spite of knowing all the causes and in spite of being watchful, there might be unexpected cases of anxiety. In the next video, we shall deal with the problem. Now, let us pause for a while and do one exercise. Whenever you experience anxiety, one thing you can do is to to start counting 1 to 10. It can provide you immediate relief from anxiety. It should be done in a particular style. Sit in a comfortable place with a relaxing posture. Just repeat after me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go on till 10. Do it when you actually in an anxious state of mind and experience for yourself the difference. Among the 5 causes accepting trauma, all remaining 4 are under your control. In the case of traumatic experience, you need external help of a doctor or a trained counselor. You will certainly be able to cope with and then overcome anxiety with external help. The other 4 causes explained above can be overcome if you spend time for yourself in self-evaluation. Make a habit of evaluating your life whenever you find time to relax and go deeper into yourself. Close your eyes. Imagine a mental screen in front of your mind and just go back into the past. Recollect, remember, and bring on the screen all your actions, all your reactions, all your responses, and all your deeds. This is a method of reliving your past. You can even relive your feelings and emotions by displaying them before the mental screen. Let go, that is, allow all data depart from your mind. This will gradually eliminate the data stored up in the unconscious mind, and your actions and your life become transparent to you. This will unburden your mind and lessen all your anxieties. Wish you, dear children, good time. Do not be anxious, but be courageous and joyful. Smile, laugh, and be of good cheer. Namaste.